idea of abstraction. But we started here. Here now, we might represent in a computer our inputs with zeros and ones.
So at this point, we've discussed inputs and we've discussed outputs, but we haven't really looked at what that that black box is of algorithms. And we're about to take several hundred Harvard students and run them through an algorithm to see how they perform.
Yeah, this was, I think, inspired by a former professor of mine in an algorithms class, I think, years ago, wherein you have everybody stand up, and you then have everyone take on the number one, so that everyone is effectively counting themselves at that moment in time in unary notation, mm-hmm. and then you have half of the audience sit down after pairing off briefly with one other member of the audience, so that all of the ones combine to twos, but then half of them sit down, and then you repeat, so then you go to four, and then eight, and then 16.
At least in theory.
Yeah. I think in 10 years of teaching CS50, I'm not sure we've ever taken an accurate attendance. But well, it's great, because every year, then you can say the bug, well, I guess that's our first bug.
Exactly. Now, they have a lesson about bugs. Behind the scenes, what's actually happening here, I think it was actually me this year, we were actually counting everybody, literally, like, one, two, three, four, like, pointing, and I think maybe there were a couple of us actually counting different areas of the room to see just how good the class compared here.
And that's actually a key detail that is very easy to forget, since there have been years where I forget to ask a member of the staff to also count because I'm a little too distracted or phased to do it in real time as well, accurately. And so I'm pretty sure we've taken a tally from the whole room. After all of this effort, someone calls out something, and I have nothing to compare it to. So preparation is the key to success with this demonstration.
And the other key preparation detail is that you have a certain program open on your computer to
yes.
handle
no,
the final
you're
tally.
Airing our dirty little secrets. Yeah, no, I am not good at arithmetic in front of hundreds of people, or even tens of people. And so I've multiple times, like, just used my phone or used an old school calculator and typed in the number, but invariably I'll forget, did I just type a number and then plus, or did I only type the number and now I have to type plus, and if you hit plus twice, it just messes
up. Yeah, you mess up the whole thing.
So I use an old Linux terminal so I can actually see everything I've typed before actually hitting enter, and that seems to help.
I mean, it's a useful tip. It kind of takes the air out of the demo at the last second if you can't show them just how buggy the implementation was.
But you have to remember, too, that it's actually helpful to finish the algorithm with students. So invariably, a number of students will be standing up because they're either too far or too confused or
too
socially uncomfortable to like actually pair off. So I just start calling out at the end to speed things up. All right, what's your number? What's your number? What's your number? And sort of manually combine people.
Right.
And so that's why we end up fixing things at the end there. And there's Miles, one of our own future teaching fellows here, pictured as a student.
Indeed.